Greetings, everybody, and welcome back once again to Far Cry 4. The few of you who are probably still watching this LP. So, I have been receiving a number of really excellent suggestions from people in the comments as to how best to go about this playthrough and make it easier to watch, and more enjoyable to watch, perhaps more importantly. And a number of those things were already things that I had planned to do. For example, varying up the live and post-commentary depending upon what's going on. Post-commentary I probably will be reserving for highlights. Live-com I'll be doing when I go through the story missions, which is what I hope to do a little bit more of this episode. And people had mainly suggested not to bother with any of the collectibles during live-com, but to just get them off-camera. And that makes perfect sense to me, especially based on the sheer number of collectibles this game seems to have. So this episode is live-com, and that being the case, I will be focusing today on some story missions. And I probably will only do a farming highlights or a side mission highlights episode when I actually have amassed enough highlights to be worth showing you guys to at least make half an hour's worth of video. But if something else happens that makes better post-com than live-com, I'll be doing that too. In any case, let's start what I think should be our next mission.
Fuck! Give him some morphine! And turn off that fucking radio!
What happened to him?
He fell. Pagan floods the airways and we have to endure his bullshit. Enough is enough! I told him to climb up the old bell tower, take over the transmitters, hijack the broadcast locally. Except...
I can do it.
Way to step up, brother. There's nobody guarding it, but it's a tricky climb. Promise me you won't fall.
I promise. I won't.
Okay, so we have to climb a bell tower? I'm guessing that's probably similar to the one we just did. What is this?
The Golden Path leaders. A two-headed elephant pulling in opposite directions and going nowhere in the end.
Nice. What's this? Masks of Valum. We're still searching for whoever is responsible for the recent spate of murders. In the meantime, all Golden Path members are instructed to remove or destroy any masks of the demon... Oh, Yalung. Valung. Mask of the demon Yalung found around the murder sites. They're a bad omen and should not be left in place. Okay, simple enough. I'm guessing that's supposed to be one of the collectibles. Okay, so where is this bell tower? Current objective. Okay, I see it. Alright, fair enough. Set a waypoint there. And I thought I saw a glider over here, and that would be really handy. Plants! Yay! I love the way he picks plants! Okay. Now, where is that glider? I remember they're marked on the map, I think. Whoops. God. Map. Damn! I keep forgetting it's the other... Okay. Sorry about that, guys. I still have to learn the positions of these vehicles. And I'm not entirely sure yet if the vehicles spawn in fixed locations, or if they're random, because sometimes they appear to be in certain spots, but then I'll come back later and they won't be there. So, I'm not sure yet quite how that works. I do really love that you can use flying vehicles in this game, or at least gliding vehicles. I keep seeing the marketing screenshots of somebody in a little kit helicopter. And that's pretty cool, too. But I have yet to find one of those. Okay, I do not want to land quite yet. I think what I'm going to do... Not, well, it looks like I have no choice. I was going to try and skirt around the side of the mountain, but... it's starting to seem clear at this point that the bell tower is at a much higher altitude. Oh, and I took damage on landing. That sucks. Oh, okay. What's this? Oh, okay. Okay. What the? What are they shooting at? What the? Was that an animal? What? Where is it? What are they even fighting? Oh, an eagle. I could have sworn I saw something over here in the bushes that they were shooting at. Ah, couldn't be important, I guess. Okay, so it looks like we have to go up there. Hey, stairs! That's awesome! Yeah, so... One of the other things that I found interesting about this game, in addition to the fact that the local language seems to be Hindi, and this is one of the reasons I think that they only had sort of a vague idea of where they wanted the game to be set, kind of a ballpark. They didn't seem to want to pin it down as... The objective point seems to be a little bit different from the actual location of the bell tower. But yeah, they check the accident site. Okay. The language being spoken here is Hindi, but a number of the other things that we see around this area, they kind of very strongly say Nepal. The presence of the Sherpas here is one such indication. For those of you who are not familiar with the Sherpas, they are... I'm not sure actually if Sherpas is the proper plural or if it's just Sherpa. Perhaps someone who is more familiar with this... Grapple. Okay. Oh, nice! Yeah, perhaps someone who is more familiar with this culture in this part of the world can clarify this for me. But from what little I know of the Sherpa people, they are sort of... sort of tribal. They're an ethnic group that lives mainly in the Nepali Himalayas. And that's really pretty much all I know. So if anybody would care to clarify that for me, or just provide some additional information on it if you know it, I would greatly appreciate it. Alright, what do I have to do here? Just swing? Okay. Looks like I might need to go down a little bit. Oh no, you know what? What am I even bothering with that for? I can just probably climb all the way up to the top. Oh, I can't. Okay. Okay. Alright, well, I guess it's gonna get a little bit more complicated. Oh no, wait! I can just, okay. Okay, well, that wasn't so bad. What's this guy got? Anything good? An opium pipe! God, here we are talking about opium in India. And it's just all over the place. That's awesome. I mean, not literally awesome, but you guys know what I mean. Okay, can I climb up here? There's clearly another spot where it looks like I'm supposed to be able to grapple, but, nope, I can't climb up here either. Alright, so... Oh, they seem to want me to make a really tricky jump. I guess I'm gonna have to just jump off and... Yeah, I'm sorry, guys. I want to be careful about this because I don't particularly want to... Oh. Okay. Can I... can I make that? Well, so much for being careful. Okay, so, clearly what I thought was originally supposed to be the solution was not the solution. Yeah. Alright, beehive. Oh, that must be it. Okay, alright. Can't see. Oh, nice. Well, I guess the bees just ate that guy. Okay, and there's someone up there that they didn't get. Whoa! Okay. God, that broadcast is really obnoxious. Okay. Is there anybody else around? Doesn't look like it, but the icons on the map... Yeah, I see some red. The icons on the map are so bunched up, I can hardly tell. Probably should rip this down while we're here. Bell towers. Hijacked the signal, liberated towers. Okay, well, this seems... Stormer, okay. I'm not sure quite what I did to unlock that, but... well, I'll take what's along my way. I won't go out of my way to try and find that stuff, but... Okay, so these additional guys are probably above me, as far as I can tell, so... I guess I'll have to just, oops. I'll have to just be careful as I'm ascending the tower. What's this? Am I supposed to... No? Oh! Okay. What about this? Really? I thought... Oh, God, I am terrible. Sorry, guys. Not this way, clearly. Here we go. This looks promising. Okay. What's this? Pagan Min wishes to remind you that the bell towers of Kirat have been officially condemned. Oh, we've read this already. Okay. What, am I meant to just walk across this? Okay, sure. I can't believe that worked. That's a little bit silly, guys. Come on. Oh, am I not? Oh, I see. Okay. All right, I got it. And clearly, wherever I see these ropes, because I see these quite a lot of different places, this seems to be a visual cue that you need to climb there. Oh, and a chest. Oh god, yeah, that sounds like some propaganda to me. I'm sorry guys, I've been being quiet so that I could hear the broadcasts, because they're so goddamn distracting. Especially when you're using headphones, as I am now. I have to use headphones when I'm doing my live commentary, because otherwise the audio from the TV speakers bleeds into my microphone. And that becomes problematic. So, yeah, for those of you who were getting irritated at me for not saying anything, that's why. I'm sorry, you know, I'll tell you what, though. Now I understand why Sabal wants these things destroyed. Oh, that's your idea of hijacking the signal, is it? okay. Oh, and it shows you some of the, some of the locations? Okay. That's pretty cool, to be honest. Oh, and it even opens up the map. Oh, okay. I only sort of glanced at this in passing before. But it seems that the map actually shows you where you can hunt different animals. That is pretty cool. Malaysian tapirs, the Assam macaque. Well, you know, guys, it's funny. This game does a better job of being a hunting simulator than all of those Cabela games from the off-camera bits of hunting that I've done so far. And that's just hilarious to me. And speaking of Assam, I'm going to have a sip of my tea here because, actually, the tea that I have today is Assam black tea. Assam just being a region of India. But it's a region of India that produces some awesome tea. Assam is, hands down, one of my favorite black teas ever. But again, as I mentioned earlier in the episode, the fact that they're kind of incorporating influences and elements from all around the general region of North India and Nepal is especially apparent in the presence of the Assam macaque and the Hindi language, while also incorporating the Sherpa people. So, I guess...
Archie, it's Sabal. Good work on the tower, brother. We're broadcasting on its frequency and bringing the truth to the people. When you have time, go see Longinus. He's a friend of the Golden Path, and he'll be grateful you helped us.
Longinus?
Weapons dealer and priest. Little crazy, but if you want guns, he's the man to see. I'll update your map.
Longinus sounds like exactly the man I want to see right about now. All right. I'm guessing it's that L. Where is it? Oh, okay. Longinus. It's interesting. Longinus is the name of the Holy Lance in biblical lore. And I guess I say it's the name of the Holy Lance. It's the name... What? Where?
Does anyone read me? We need immediate assistance.
Where? What?
If anyone's there, pick up! This is urgent!
Desperate need of supply. Oh, okay.
Assistance required.
That looks like a side mission, so I'm going to hold off on it for now.
Does anyone read me? We need immediate assistance.
I'm quite sure that there was a glider somewhere around here. Yes, there is. Okay, so straight ahead of me there. Excellent. Going to take that. But yeah, the Holy Lance, Longinus was the name of the Roman soldier who basically stabbed Jesus Christ with his lance during the crucifixion. And the lance itself later came to be known by the name of Longinus, which was originally the name of the soldier to whom it belonged. And the Lance of Longinus appears not just in biblical lore, but in a very large number of video games. It appeared in Persona 2, in fact. It was obtained somehow by Hitler, whom actually, in real life, was trying to find the Holy Grail, or so it is said. But in the game, he gets his hands on the Lance of Longinus, and... probably gonna crash here. Yup. Excellent 6-point landing. But yeah, the Lance of Longinus is said to have been responsible for some fairly impressive feats of power. It somehow, after the crucifixion, in the years subsequent to that, it ended up in the possession of a king. And I forget of what land he was the king, but, somebody who was interacting with him at some point got into an argument with him, I guess, and picked up the Lance of Longinus, which I guess was just lying around, and stabbed him with it. And he died. His entire kingdom basically exploded. Like, it fell apart, and the land died, and his kingdom just ceased to exist. I'm guessing Longinus is in here.
Guns?
Of course! Well, the meek shall inherit the earth, my friend. All they need are some good guns. Revelation 5:5. It is the most invigorating weed. And one of the elders saith unto me, weep not! Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, hath prevailed to open the book and loose the 7 seals thereof. Tis our Savior. It is our Savior returned to us as a lion, a warrior. So, I started thinking to myself, when the Son of God is reborn, what gun would he use? When Christ returns to break the 7 seals and bring about the rapture, he returns as a lion, yes? A lion needs teeth. What gun would Jesus choose? Deuteronomy 32:47, for there are no empty words for you, but your very life. Or maybe Revelation 19:11, the discretion of a man deferreth his anger.
I don't know what you're talking
about. A soldier knows. A soldier always knows, for we have seen the rapture and survived it. You need guns to do righteous work, AJ. For every gun is a Bible. For every bullet, a sermon. And for every radio tower that you free from pagans' lies, I will give you something. A reward. It is the will of God. Here. This is for the first one.
Vandaport is under attack! We need fighters here,
Sabah,
now!
Sabah, what's happening?
We're under attack! Stay away!
Oh, shit!
Go forth into all the world and proclaim the gospel to the whole of creation!
Wow. Okay, now I know why he calls himself Longinus. Alright, well... I'd probably better focus on driving. Where on earth... Oh, I've got my work cut out for me getting back to Bhanupur. I probably am not going to... Current objective. Okay. God, I have to go that way? Oh, dear. All right. Whatever will be, will be. Whoops. Oh. So yeah. Longinus? What a compelling character.
I wish you could remember what it was like back then, Audrey. Your mother and I, with you on her hip. Oh, those were the days. She was never happier than she was back then, and I should say the same for myself. We had such plans, not just for our little family, but for Kirat. It wasn't always like this. I long for those days, but then it's too late. I tried. I really, really did, but this place is ruinous. Try not to let them drive you down, Audrey. Ishwari didn't send you back here for that.
What an interesting cast of characters this game has. Nope, that's clearly not the right way. Wow, so much going on here. Alright, well, I guess I better get back to Bonapur and save Sabal and everybody. What? What? Those guys were wearing, Oh, for crying out loud. They were wearing Golden Path uniforms. I didn't want to just shoot them. Or run them over. Oh, for God's sake. Screw it, I'm just getting out of here. God, that healing animation. Okay. Sheesh. Well, that was not how I wanted to make my return. Clear the village of army soldiers. Okay, I'm gonna ditch that waypoint then. Oh, it was already ditched apparently. Alright. Well, that sucks. Oh, and I hear a chopper. Where? Oh! Oh, I don't think I'm going to be able to scratch it with this. This is not an anti-aircraft weapon. Oh, okay. Well. Oh. Well. That was probably not the best vantage point. Ah well, I'll get him next time.
I'm here, Sabal. How can I help?
Damn it! Keep your head down and save whoever you can. I'm not far. I'll be there soon with help.
Alright, let's try this again. What in... Where is that chopper? I hear him. Oh, okay. No, I don't think there's any way. Whoa. Who... Where? Lots going on here, clearly. Alright, where is everybody? Uh-oh. Oh, okay. Somebody is throwing Molotovs at me. I can't see through that smoke. I see people on the mini-map. I cannot see them visually. Unable to get visual confirmation. Okay, maybe if I sneak around this way. God, I cannot see when Ajay holds his rifle up. Oh, jeez. And there's no real cover here to speak of. Oh, well, okay. What? Wow. Okay, I am not used to this. Combat against animals is clearly not the same thing as combat against humans. I can't even climb this. Did I get him? Nope. Uh-oh. I cannot see anybody. These guys. Oh. Oh, for God's sake, that killed a civilian. I couldn't even see her around the corner. What was I supposed to do? One guy. He appears to be nope, he's facing this way now. What the hell? Oh, God. Is he inside? I can't get in through the door. I probably should not have shot him in the feet. Oh, God. Whoa. Oh, this is not going well. Ah, you idiot. You just killed yourself. Ah, crap. Reloading. I almost just ate my words. It's just as they say. Talk shit, get hit. Right, where are the other enemies? Couple more, it looks like. I hear a chopper. Nope, maybe I'm just imagining things. I saw you first! Wait, no. Okay. Now I hear the chopper. Where is it? Okay. So he's probably bringing more enemies. Screw it. Oh, and now I'm out of ammunition. Alright, so maybe instead of shooting the chopper this time, maybe I should try a different approach. I'll save my small arms ammunition for the soldiers, and I'll see if I can hit the chopper with something a little bit more... something a little bit more dangerous. Because you must be able to destroy the chopper. You must. Well then! Oh, there's another one! Wonderful. Okay, well, I've got some Molotovs still. Ah! Nice!
Andre, get her out!
Everything is on fire!
Okay, so, that's fascinating. There is a, oh, it's this way. There is a simple solution. Okay, where are these guys? I better stop them. Oh dear. What am I supposed to do here? Ah! Find a way inside the building. God, I'm gonna die from fire before I even get in. Behind it? Okay. Where on earth? Oh, I should have just done this. Okay.
Badra, where are you?
Oh, that ain't good.
I'm all right.
The people need to see her. It'll comfort them.
She's just a child, Sabal, and she's terrified. I'll take her home, and then we'll worry about the people, okay? Thank you.
You're okay.
This is what we get for rescuing Ajay. We hit Paul's house, he slaughters a village.
This isn't on Ajay, it's on me. We can't worry about that now. They took the outpost, and they have hostages.
Fine. The outpost first. Without it, we're cut off from the others. Come.
Wow, okay, well... That... sucks. Alright, I have to wonder, guys.
Brother, we need to talk.
Sabal, what is it?
I'm needed in Banipur, and Amita is focused on the outpost. So it's up to you to help with the hostages. I know it's a lot to ask, but they must be rescued before we take back the outpost.
But Amita said...
The outpost is important, but our top priority should be the lives of those hostages. The people of Kirat depend on the Golden Path for protection. We cannot let them down. Rescue the hostages, brother.
Wow, okay, right into another mission right away? I was gonna end the episode, but,
The Golden Path needs to kill Pagan and all his followers. This cannot go unanswered.
Alright, yeah, I guess. We might as well just finish this up. Now... Oh, okay. Alright, so let's, before anything else, we'll refill our ammunition. We'll get some body armor, so hopefully I won't die any more embarrassing deaths. And we'll sell all the crap I don't need. Are there any weapons that I can buy which might be helpful for this? I apparently already have the scorpion. Oh, but you know what? It's looking like the STG-90 is probably a better weapon than the MP4, or the MP34, as far as the game is concerned. Well, you know what? I guess we'll switch. And can I... What can we get? We can get an extended mag and a red dot sight. Oh, and it looks like the sight actually increases the weapon's attributes. Interesting. Well, ammunition is clearly an issue, but I like the fact that this increases mobility and accuracy. I think I'm just going to go with the red dot sight. And... oh, and it seems that it can actually use more ammunition because I'm able to carry more.
Look Everything at what Megan may I have done.
Is gone. What am I going to do now?
Okay, well, yeah, I was going to say sorry about that, guys. I definitely did not do the best job of that mission, but I was kind of hoping to be able to stealth it. And as it turned out, it does not seem stealth was possible. I was going to ask you guys if, for those of you who have played this game and are more experienced with it, is it even possible to stealth that mission? Because right when I showed up, there were already guys shooting at me. And granted, I probably just approached it from the wrong spot. But, yeah. Once again, sorry for all the bad play there. That is not something that I've had a chance to experience yet in this game. The sort of frontal rush-in combat. But then again, this isn't exactly a game that's designed around, or designed solely around anyway, stealthing everything. It's clearly intended to give you the option of doing so if you want. And it does seem to reward you, because stealth is clearly a little bit harder to do. And in fact, it's considerably harder to do, if the experience I just had was any indication. But, I don't know, it seems like they intend for you to be fully able to just run in with guns blazing and start throwing grenades and firing RPGs. So I'm glad that the game is versatile enough to accommodate multiple different play styles. Alright. Can I slide down this? Seems I can. I really appreciate that sliding down a slope like that does not instantly kill you when you land, as it does in some other games. Showing I'm only 160-ish meters from the target, so hopefully I shouldn't have too much farther to go. Oh, birds! Cute little buggers. But I guess 160 meters is a long way on foot. Kill the guards and save at least two hot... okay, so this clearly you have to stealth. And it's neat that they give you a little running slide into the crouch. Where are they? Oh, they're up there. Okay. All right. Okay, I'm closing in on it now. Let's see. Oh, this is the time when I really wish I had a weapon that was suited to stealth. Alright, they are going to probably slaughter the hostages as soon as I start shooting. So instead... now the only problem is, I hope whatever animal this summons does not start killing hostages. Yes, I know that already. I should probably scope this out with my camera too, huh? Ah, damn it. One of the hints that people were kind enough to give me in the comments was that I should tag all of the enemies. Preferably that I should do so from a vantage point up high. So actually... oh, yeah, and that appears to be what this is intended for. Undo the survivors for an extra reward. Okay. Arrows. Wait a minute, is there a bow here? There is. Okay. So this is probably a better option for me for this mission. I definitely need... definitely need a... should be able to pick up these arrows. There we go, okay. Definitely need a quieter weapon than that machine gun. Okay, yeah, I should be able to see everybody much better from here. I have a feeling this is probably what people were yelling at me to do in the comments. But it doesn't look like there's anybody else around, just a couple of guards. Alright. Oh, wow, okay, and there's even a key. Wait a minute, what's that lightning bolt mean? Chaser, okay. Alright. In that case... Ah, crap. Well, that did not go at all the way I hoped. Oh, that's handy, and there's a nice little shortcut here. Excellent. It's also helpful that they give us a bow right nearby. I appreciate that immensely. Alright, let's try this again. So, no matter what you do, this mission is going to challenge you. If you decide to go in guns blazing, you've got to be damn quick about it. And if you decide to stealth it, you've got to be really careful. I like that, though. There is definitely an element of challenge to this game. It's not just a casual shooter. No, you know what? I need to isolate these guys, and I need to get a little closer. Oh, okay, so there are quite a few more, then. There are several over here. Okay. I also need some better cover. Actually, I wonder if this will work. Yeah, it seems it did, but now I need to get a little closer. Okay. There. I can't see. I need to get rid of at least one of these guys before I'm going to be able to sneak in, though. Oh, okay. That was a little bit easier than I had expected. Gotcha. Okay, I think I can do this. I think I'll manage.
Help is on the way. Help is on the way.
Okay, that's a hostage. Alright, there's another guy.
These guys won't bother keeping us alive. What are we going to do?
Actually... Oh, I have to kill all the guards first. Okay, well... First, let me get this guy's body out of the way. Ah, Ah, wrong button. There we go. We'll just put him right in here. Alright, now for these other twerps. On patrol, eh? Ha! That was satisfying. Next! Wait. Oh god. Bees! Not the bees! Ah, my eyes! Alright. Oh, this guy ate shit. Right in the neck. Only two more guards left, it looks like, though, so we're doing okay. Is going to be getting them away from each other. Gotcha, idiot. Now there's nothing your buddy can do. Ha! Flawless victory.
The hostages are safe, Sabal.
You're doing your father's name proud, Ajay. This is what he wanted when he created the Golden Path, to help his people.
Look, I didn't come here for my father or any of this.
We could still use your help, brother. Look at the difference you've made. I know, I'm asking a lot from you, but helping the Golden Path will take you to Lakshmana. I promise you that. We'll find it together.
Thanks, Sabal.
Ajay, it's Amita. I know that Sabal put you up to rescuing the hostages instead of taking back the outpost. Okay. You're new here, and Sabal can be very persuasive.
I just wanted to do my part.
And I appreciate that, but you have to see the bigger picture. I was already making arrangements to deal with the outpost, but now I have to retask my fighters so they can protect the hostages you rescued.
Protect them from what?
Deplore. He doesn't like losing his playthings. Don't you see, Ajay? There was a plan, and now it's fallen apart. It will be a while before things with Deplore blow over. Meanwhile, the enemy soldiers in that outpost will have plenty of time to dig in.
Not if I can help it.
Ajay, attacking that outpost on your own would be suicide. Wait until we can give you the proper support.
I can do this, Amita.
Ajay, don't...
Nice. Excellent. Okay, so it seems to me that there are progressions of story here which are continuous. So that being the case, I'm going to wrap the episode up here. I had thought that I would finish it at the end of the last mission, but then the last mission led to this one, and this mission...
Ajay?
Yes?
Awesome. Oh, just making sure you've been listening.
What the hell? Oh, Pagan Min, you sly cat. Alright, well, as I said, I will eventually get good. So, thank you all for bearing with me. I've got to say, that mission was really cool. The stealth aspect was a lot of fun, and I definitely appreciate the fact that these missions seem to be balanced around more than just a single style of play. I probably could have pulled it off somehow had I decided to just charge in and shoot everybody, but it was a little bit more rewarding getting it done the way I did. And now that I've successfully completed one of those sorts of missions, I have a much, much better idea of how they're going to go, more than likely anyway, throughout the rest of the game. So, if any of you are still with me at this point, thank you all for sticking with me, and I will see you all next episode. Yay!